In the decision problem SetCover, we are given a set, a universe, U, of elements, and a collection of subsets of U, S1 to Sm. We are also given an integer k. The question is whether we can select no more than k of the subsets in such a way that the union of those sets covers the entire universe. So the union of the selected sets should be equal to the set U. So here's an example. The universe might just be the numbers 1 to 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. The value k might be 2. And we will have 6 subsets of U. S1 contains the numbers 3 and 7. S2 contains the numbers 3, 4, 5, and 6. S3 contains the number 1. S4 contains the number 2 and 4. S5 contains the number 5. And S6 contains the numbers 1, 2, 6, and 7. So now the question is whether we can select 2 of those 6 sets so that their union is equal to U. And the answer here is yes, we can select the second and the sixth set, and that gives us all the numbers, because 1 and 2 is contained in set S6, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are contained in set S2, and 7 is contained in set S6 again. Sometimes a reduction can be quite simple. If we want to reduce a problem X to a problem Y, where X is a special case of the problem Y, then a reduction might be quite straightforward. SetCover can be seen as a more general version of VertexCover, and therefore it's not too difficult to see that VertexCover polynomial time car produces to SetCover. Here's how this reduction works. In VertexCover, we are given a graph and a number k as an input. We now have to transform this somehow into an input for SetCover. In our construction, for our universe in the SetCover instance, we use the set of the edges of the graph G. Now we create, for each vertex in the graph, a subset of this universe. So for a vertex V, we would create a subset SV that consists of all the edges that are incident to the vertex V. And our number k, remember we want to have at most k of the subsets whose union is then equal to U. For the number k, we just use the same number k that we got as an input for vertex cover. Now, with this construction, we have the property that there is a set cover of size at most k, if and only if there was a vertex cover of size at most k in the original graph. Here's an example of a graph with 6 nodes and 7 edges. And we will transform this into a set cover instance as follows. We have 7 edges, so the universe would have 7 elements. And we would have a subset for each vertex. So for vertex A, we would have a subset consisting of all edges that are incident to vertex A. So these are edges 3 and 7. And then we have a vertex B, and we indicate all the incident edges for vertex B, which are 2 and 4. And then we have vertex C with 3, 4, 5, and 6 as the incident edges, and so on. This graph has a vertex cover of size 2, and our constructed set cover instance also has a set cover of size 2. As a set cover, we can use the set SC and SF. Their union would include all the elements from 1 to 7. And if we select the corresponding vertices in the graph, so the vertex C and the vertex F, that is a vertex cover of size 2. So for all edges, at least one of the endpoints is either a vertex C or vertex F. We can also make this construction in polynomial time because, well, the universe is just the set of all the edges, the value k is just copied, and then we need to construct these subsets for each vertex in the graph. But basically, we just go through each vertex. For each vertex, we construct a subset, and the size of these subsets is at most the number of edges in the graph. So all of this is polynomial, and this can be easily implemented efficiently.